Hello everyone, this is Shikha, your English teacher. Today we are going to start with the first English course book, First Flight. I'm going to start with the chapter 1, A Letter to God, and give you the line by line explanation. You all are supposed to listen to the explanation very carefully, note down all the hard words and try to give the explanation yourselves later on. Okay, so here we start. Chapter number 1, A Letter to God. Now before we start this story, I would like to tell you this story is about having faith on God. Means they say faith can move the mountains, but what should we put our faith in? This is the question in this story delicately poses by a farmer Lencho, who wrote a letter to God to complete his wish. Now his wish is going to be fulfilled by God or not? His faith is kept by God or not? As we go on the chapter, we are going to know. The house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. Now there is a single house on the valley. Valley is something means in between, the under part means on the both side there are big mountains, and between those big mountain there is valley that is full of water, flowers, and so many vegetations are there. Okay, so there was one single house and on the crest of low hill means there was a low hill, low mountain, and on the top of the mountain a single house was there. Crest is called top of the mountain. From this height one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted with the flowers that always promised a good harvest. Means on the top, from the top of that house one can see the flowing river from there. Everyone can see the flowers that is bloomed in the valleys that always promised. Means they are always going to be turned into a good harvest. Harvest is called crop. The only thing the earth needed was a downpour or at least a shower. Now for good harvest, for good crop, what is earth needed? That is called downpour. Downpours means heavy rain, and the least of shower means low rain. Okay, so rain is very much essential so that we can have the good crop. Throughout the morning, Lencho, who knew his fields intimately, had done nothing else but to see the sky towards the northeast. Means every morning Lencho came out. Lencho is the name of farmer, the character of this story, who came out in the fields. He is owning a big field, and intimately is called very closely, very nearly. So he likes his fields very closely, and every time he just saw upon the sky about whether the black clouds are coming from the northeast direction bringing the rain or not. Now we are really going to get some water, woman. Now Lencho is saying to a woman, addressing a woman, maybe his wife. Now it seems we are going to get a shower, means we are going to have rain. The woman who was preparing supper, supper is called dinner, the evening meal. So she was in kitchen and she was preparing the evening meal, replied, yes, God willing. Whatever the God wish, she replied. The older boys were working in the fields while the smaller ones were playing near the house until the woman called to them all, come for dinner. Now Lencho is the farmer. He is having wife and he is having boys. The elder boy, his elder son was working in field and his younger son was playing outside. Then his mother called, come for dinner. It was during the meal that... Now they are having the meal, and between the meal they start talking. Just as Lencho had predicted, big drops of rain begin to fall. Now Lencho was in the sense of like rain is about to come, and this thing he also shared with his wife. And as he said, rain started coming. Predicted is called when you are foretelling something, when you are telling something about future. In the northeast, huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. Now from the northeast direction, from behind the cloud, very black and big clouds can be seen that are coming towards this side. The air was fresh and sweet. The Fresh and sweet air was blowing on. The man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. Now Lencho went out and he wanted to just feel out the drops of the rain on his body, that's why he came out from his house. And when he returned, he exclaimed is called to excited, very excited, and to say with joy. So when he came back, he was very excited and said, these are not raindrops falling from the sky, they are new coins. Now the rain started and he was saying, this is not the rain, this is not the drop of the rains, but these are the silver coins. The big drops are 10 cent pieces and the little ones are 5s, meaning the big drops, whatever the big drops of the rain were coming, that looking like 10 paise, and the small drops of the rain were looking like 5 paise. With a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with its flowers draped in a curtain of rain. Now he was very satisfied, and the satisfactory expressions can be seen on his face, and he regarded the field. Regarded means to suppose, to see, and he regarded his field of the ripe corn. The field was of corn that is going to be ripe with the flowers. Okay, and draped is called covered. You know what is the curtain? Curtain is there. Curtain is a type of fabric. So his field was looking like that. All the ripe corn field was draped or was covered in the curtain of rain, means so the rain was so fast and so that covered all the cornfield at once. But suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain very large hailstones began to fall. But in no time the rain started getting very heavy, and the hailstone called the pieces of the ice that comes when very heavy rain comes, that is called ole. Okay, so many hailstones begin to fall with the rain. These truly did resemble new silver coin. Now these hailstorms are looking like absolutely new silver coins. The boys exposing themselves to the rain ran out to collect the frozen pearls. Now Lencho's boys came out from the house and they started collecting these hailstones that are looking like in the form of the silver coins. It's really getting bad now, exclaimed the man. Now men was exclaiming, means speaking in the loud voice, it is not going to be good for me. I hope it passes quickly. Now he wishes that this hailstorm should go very quickly. It did not pass quickly, but exactly the opposite thing happened, and the rain continues and the hailstorm started and continues to fall down. For an hour, the hail rained on the house, the garden, the hillside, the cornfield, on the whole valley. Now, these hailstorm rain, the rain with the hailstorm continues till 1 hour, and it is covered all the garden, all the hillside, or his all the Lencho field, cornfield, and the complete valley was filled with the hailstorm. The field was white as it covered with the salt. Now all the field looking like that, it is covered with the white salt. Not a leaf remained on the trees. The corn was totally destroyed. Now Lencho can see, after the rain stopped, Lencho came out the field and his all crop was destroyed by the hailstorm. The flowers were gone from the plants. No flower was there, not a single plant, not a single flower was remained on the field. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. Now Lencho became really very sad. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his sons, a plague of locust would come. Now he was standing in the middle of the field, and with a great sadness he was addressing his sons and tell, this is a type of locust plague. Locust is a type of insect that you called tiddidal, which are coming in the groups and they can destroy the full field. Okay, means locusts are the enemies for the crops. So he was just addressing the hailstorm and comparing hailstorm with locust, a type of insect that destroys the complete crop. A plague of locust must have left more than this. Now Lencho was saying to his son, if the locust would have come, even then they can leave some of the crops, but the hail has left nothing, but this hailstorm destroyed my full crop. This year we will have no corn. Now he's saying with very sadness, this year we are not going to have any crop, any corn. That night was a sorrowful one. Means that night they cannot sleep and they all were very sad. All our work for nothing. Whatever the hard work we have done till now, that are all wasted. There is no one who can help us. We all go hungry this year. Now there is nobody. Lencho was just remembering, just thinking and having so much sadness in his heart that he was saying, now what we are going to do? Who is going to help us? Now we are going to remain hungry for the whole year. But in the hearts of all who lived in that solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope, help from God. In the beginning of the chapter, it is mentioned very clearly, Lencho was having only house in the valley on the top of the hill. So there was nobody else whose help Lencho can supposed to get except the God. Okay. And solitary is called alone, lonely. Okay. So in the middle of the valley, only one house of the Lencho's house was there. And he was now just hoping of the help of God only. Don't be so upset, even though this seems like a total loss. Remember, no one dies of hunger. Means this is the sound of his conscience. This is the sound of his heart that was consoling him that, Lencho, there is no need to get upset. Each and every problem has a solution. Now remember, nobody is going to die with hunger. Means if the man can do hard work, he's not going to die with hunger. That's what they say, no one dies of hunger. That's why it is said, if the man is going to be hard worker, then he cannot die just because of hunger. All through the night, Lencho thought only of his one hope, the help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, see everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. Now, all through the night means Lencho was not able to sleep for full night, and he was continuously thinking and having only one hope was remained in his heart, and that was means there was nobody who can help him except the God. Means he was in the faith that it is the God eyes that can see everything, that can be instructed. Instructed is called to give instruction, to give you some guidance. See everything means God eyes can see everything. There is nothing to tell. God is there. Whatever good and bad is going to happen in this world, God can see with his own eyes anytime, anywhere. Even what is deep in one's conscience. Now conscience is called one's heart, one's soul, one's spirit. Okay. Means God can see whatever is happening in the world, outside of the world. And he was so powerful, he was so mighty that he can also see what is going on in the man's heart. Lencho was an ox of a man. Now ox of a man is determined means Lencho was very hard working. You must have seen the ox are going to plow the field. Two oxes were huddled in a plow and they were going to plow a field. Means they are very hard working. So Lencho was compared with the ox, that he worked really hard, working like an animal in the field, but still he knew how to ride. Means this is showing means a farmer. He was a farmer. He can work very hard in the field to grow the crop, but he was not illiterate. He can write. He can read. Means he was a literate person. The following Sunday at daybreak, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to town and place in the email. Now he was thinking, I'm going to write a letter, and he himself will go to the post office of the town and he's going to post that letter. It was nothing less than a letter to God. Now he was hoping to get help, but there was no one except the God. So he was thinking to write a letter directly to God. Now he started writing a letter. God, he wrote, if you don't help me, my family and I'll go hungry this year. Now he wrote in the letter about if God is not going to help him, he with his family is going to die of hunger. I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again and to live until the crop comes because the hailstorm. Now he is writing again, continuing the letter. What he wants exactly 100 pesos. Now pesos is the currency of Latin American countries like Spain, Mexico. In these type of countries, like we have a currency rupee, same as the Latin American countries are having the currency that is named pesos. So he needed 100 pesos so that he can sow the crop again in his field and grow the crop again in his field because his all crop has been destroyed by hailstorm. He wrote to God on the envelope, put the letter inside, and still troubled, went to town. Now after writing the letter, he put the letter in the envelope and went to post it in the town. At the post office, he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. Now, to post the letter, before posting the letter, we need to put a stamp. A stamp is a type of sticker, that is a mailing sticker, you can say, that we need to put on the envelope before posting the letter. So he just put the stamp on the letter and then dropped the letter in mailbox. There is a type of boxes there in which, and there is a window, from that window you can put your hand inside and drop the letter in that mailbox. Then the postman will come, open that mailbox and take out your letter. Okay. Not a leaf remained on the trees. The corn was totally destroyed. Now Lencho can see after the rain stopped, Lencho came out the field and his all crop was destroyed by the hailstorm. The flowers were gone from the plants. No flower was there, not a single plant, not a single flower was remained on the field. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. Now Lencho became really very sad. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his sons, a plague of locust would come. Now he was standing in the middle of the field and with a great sadness, he was addressing his sons and tell, this is a type of locust plague. Locust is a type of insect that you called tiddidal, which are coming in the groups and they can destroy the full field. Okay, means locusts are the enemies for the crops. So he was just addressing the hailstorm and comparing hailstorm with locust, a type of insect that destroys the complete crop. So in order not to shake the writer's faith in God, the postmaster came up with an idea. Now postmaster was thinking, if the man is having so much faith on the God, let's this faith be remained on the God. And now postmaster got an idea. Answer the letter means he is just going to write a letter from the side of God. But when he opened it, it was evident that to answer it, he needed something more than goodwill, ink and paper. But when he opened the envelope, take out the letter, read the read the letter, then came to know that he need many more things to complete the answer. Evident is called proof, means the letter was giving him proof that he needed something else than goodwill. Goodwill is called to become friendly, to become cooperative. Okay, so besides become friendly, besides needed paper, he needs something else to write the answer. But he stuck to his resolution. Stuck is called when you are fixed at some place. Okay, so resolution is called determination. Okay, when you are determined, very much confident to do something. So he was very much determined that he is going to give the answer. He asked for money from his employees. He himself gave a part of his salary. Means if he is going to give the answer, he has to put the money that Lencho asked from God. Okay, so for collecting this money, he asked from his employees that you all are going to give some share of money. I'm also giving some share of money from my salary. And several friends of his were obliged to give something for an act of charity. Now, postmaster was taking this thing as a type of charity because he knew the condition, the bad condition of Lencho after reading the letter, that Lencho was in trouble and we should help him. So everybody was very obliged. Obliged is called very much of to give someone, to give the support to anyone to complete, to take out from the problem. So everybody was very obliged. Everybody was so honored to give some share of their salary in the part of this charity. It was impossible for him to gather together 100 pesos, so he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half. Now for postmaster, it is not easy to collect 100 pesos, so he collected more than half, means half was 50 pesos. So more than 50 pesos he collected for farmer. He put the money in an envelope addressed to Lencho and with it a letter containing only a single word as a signature, God. Now he collected all the money, put it in the envelope. Now with this money, he also wrote a letter and made only the signature of God, means only one word was there in letter, God, means this letter was coming from the God. And then he wrote the address of Lencho and sent it to Lencho's address. Now containing is something called, means keeping something. Okay, so all letter is keeping only one word, that was the word of name of God. Now, the following Sunday, Lencho came a bit earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter for him. Now, on coming Sunday, Lencho himself came to post office to ask whether any of the letter has come for him or not. It was the postman himself who handed the letter to him, while the postmaster, experiencing the contentment of a man who has performed a good deed, looked on form of his office. Now he postman who handed over the letter, yes, there is a letter for you, and he handed over the letter to Lencho. And the postmaster sitting inside the post office, he was experiencing a type of contentment. Contentment is called satisfaction, means he was very satisfied because he has helped a person who was in need. Lencho showed not a slightest surprise on seeing the money. Such was his confidence. Now see, Lencho opened the letter and take out the letter, but he was not surprised. Means he was having so much faith on God that he was so confident that he is going to get the answer. Means can you imagine if you write a letter to God, then you can believe that God would give you the reply. But see, Lencho is having so much faith in God that he was not surprised. At least slightest means a little surprise was not there. He was not a little wondered on getting the reply from God, but he became angry when he counted the money. Now see, at one side God replied him, and at other side Lencho became angry after getting the letter from the side of God. And why he was angry? Because the money he wrote in the letter from the God, the money was not complete. God could not have made a mistake, nor could he have denied Lencho what he had requested. Means God has not made the mistake. Means this cannot be said that God has not kept the money. God has kept the money. God had not made made Lencho total angry. But God also keep the request from the side of Lencho, but he has not completed the Lencho's request completely. Immediately Lencho went up to the window to ask for paper and ink. Now again, after finding money, after reading the letter, Lencho came to the window of post office and asked, give me a paper and ink. On the public writing table, he started to write. Now he is giving reply to God, okay. So he started writing on the table. There was a table in the post office, okay. See, he kept the paper there and started writing. With much wrinkling of his brow. Now wrinkling is called something when you have lines, and brow is called eyebrows. Means when you have wrinkle on your lines, when you turn your lines, when you curve your eyebrows, means you are getting angry. Means Lencho was in a angry mood, okay. I mean, with angry mood he was writing a letter, caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. Means he has to write, he has to put his ideas, what he want to write in the letter. This is going to be showed with the effort. Why effort is called? When you try, so much of trial, okay. Because he was getting a little bit of anger in his heart. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stamp, which he licked, okay. And after completing the letter, if you need to post the letter again, you need to put that stamp. So he went on the window and asked for a stamp. Now he licked. Licked means when you are licking something with your tongue, when you are putting your saliva on with your tongue and to fix it. Means stamp needs something to fix it. So he licked the stamp and put. So he asked for a stamp, he licked and then affixed to the envelope. Affixed is called to fix, to put the stamp on the envelope. With a blow of his fist, means he make a punch and just tap on the table hard, and the stamp is fixed on the envelope. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster went to open it. Means Lencho dropped the letter in the mailbox and he went, and then postmaster come and quickly take out the letter. It said, God, of the money that I asked for, only 70 pesos reached me. Now in the letter, Lencho wrote to God, God, you gave me only 70 pesos. Means in the, when I opened the envelope, I found only 70 pesos and I asked for 100 pesos. Send me the rest since I need it very much. Now in following line he was writing, send me the remaining money. Means he was 30 pesos more because he was much needy. But don't send it to me through the mail, because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks, Lencho. Now he was writing that don't send me by post. Means don't write me a letter. Just try find another way to send me the rest of the money, because I am thinking you must have sent the complete money. Means you must have sent me the 100 pesos. But the employee, who the worker of this post office, are very crook. Crook is called rude or very much cruel. Okay, they have taken out my money and I got only 7 pesos. Now see the irony. Means at one side, postmaster unknowingly helped Lencho, but Lencho was thinking that the worker of the post office dished him. Okay, so here we have completed the chapter. I have explained very thoroughly each and every line. You listen to the audio and try to explain the chapter yourself. We'll meet again. That's it for now.